Today's automotive market would tell you that crossovers are the future, and that's probably true, but for Volkswagen, sedans are still big business. In fact, they make up 29% of its sales, and that is why VW is updating its most popular, best-known product, that's still in production anyways, the Jetta. Here we're taking a look at the new Jetta and the Jetta GLI for 2022. Before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe to Motor One for more content like this, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and wherever else you get your social media. Now, Volkswagen has largely followed the classic strategy for a mid-cycle refresh. This grille is slightly larger and slightly more expressive, and the front fascia is updated. You get these really great LED accent lights there that look quite cool. The GLI sees similar changes up front with a new grille and front fascia, but the big news is out back, where there's a revised rear bumper that houses a all new exhaust setup that features a gorgeous set of big chrome pipes. We can't wait to hear what it sounds like. The big interior changes happen on the GLI, where there is a new upholstery that adds a red underlayer that kind of spices up the cabin. You'll also get a new steering wheel. Now, this has the same touch capacitive buttons as you'll see in the new Golf GTI and Golf R, and we don't love that. Those buttons are a little bit difficult to use, but it is what it is. The big news in the standard Jetta is that every version will come standard with Volkswagen Digital Cockpit. Now, you'll get a smaller 8-inch screen on the base models, but the higher-end models feature the same 10-inch display found on the GLI. There will also be an IQ drive package that adds a host of active safety features, including adaptive cruise control, lane keeping assist, and headlight assist, among other aids. That'll be standard on the top-end Jetta trims, but it'll be an option on the two lower-end models.
Volkswagen is leaving the GLI's turbocharged 2-liter engine alone. With 228 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque, it didn't really need much massaging in the first place. As with last year's cars, owners can pair the 2-liter to either a 6-speed manual transmission or a 7-speed dual clutch. On the standard Jetta, there's more news, as VW is replacing last year's 1.4-liter engine with the turbocharged 1.5-liter from the Taos crossover. Technically still a part of the same engine family, the 1.5-liter produces 158 horsepower and 184 pound-feet of torque. That's an improvement of 11 horsepower, although torque remains the same, as do the available gearboxes. There's a no-cost 6-speed manual on the Jetta S and new Jetta Sport, while the SE and SEL trims carry a standard 8-speed automatic.
Volkswagen didn't really break new ground in facelifting the Jetta, but then it didn't really need to. All the company needed was to keep this car feeling fresh enough to compete with the updated Honda Civic and Hyundai Elantra, and in that regard, more safety features and a slight boost in power is just what the doctor ordered. For much more, check out MotorOne.com. I'm Brandon Turkus.